Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Go ahead, Minister Orville, you pray.
Father, we come before you this afternoon, God, believing that you're going to touch, you're going to heal, you're going to deliver. We honor the name that is above all name. God, it's not about us, but it's about you. It's about what you have ordained from before the foundation of the world. We thank you, God, for the outcome, God, your word that we are going to share today. God, the things that will be discussed during this podcast, God, we pray for Sister Astrid health right now in the name of Jesus. We pray that the Shekinah glory, God, as Mary said, how will this thing be? And the angel Gabriel answered, the Holy Ghost shall come upon you, and the power
Amen.
of the
Thank you,
Most
Jesus.
High shall overshadow you, God. We pray, God, that she will have an experience as never before in 2024. God, this is a year of open door. This is a year, God, of recompense. This is the year, God, that you have ordained for those that trust you and believe on your name. We thank you, God, for everyone that's going to be on this podcast, every minister, God, every person that you have called, God, with a holy calling. Thank you, God, for the things that you are doing, you have done, and you're going to do. I do believe, God, that we are in the best season and time of humanity, God, where you have declared through your prophet Joel that you will pour out your spirit upon all flesh and that our sons and our daughters will prophesy, God, recalling those things that are not as though they were. We believe that there is still power in your word. We believe, God, that the things that you have spoken through your word will come to pass even in this age and time. Thank you, God, for the many years that you have kept this podcast open. Thank you, God, for the willingness that you have placed in our hearts, God, to continue to spread your word, God, to the lost, God, to the weak, to the one that is in need. We pray that today will be just a special day in somebody's life. We pray that you will touch today. We pray that they will understand that there is still power in prayer, that they may understand that they can call upon you as your word declare, call upon me, and I will answer you, and I will show you great and mighty things that thou knowest not of. We call those things today into existence, God. We claim, God, every promise in the word from Genesis to Revelation. Hallelujah. We claim healing for our bodies, for our mind, for our soul.
Yes, God, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, that hedge of protection, because he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. God, we declare and we know that we have been handpicked and called and ordained with a holy calling, God, that you have called us with a purpose, God. We're not accident, we're not casualty, but we are purpose, God, because you have called us for such a time as this. Thank you, God, for every one of these episodes. Thank you, God, for the way you have instructed and laid upon your servant's heart, God, to share your word. We thank you, God, in advance, and we anticipate, God, what you're about to do through this podcast once again. Thank you for your presence, because your word declared that where two or three are gathered in your name, they are you in the midst of them, and we know that you are here, and that you will put words in our mouths, and the words in our mouth will be as fire, and he that heareth, God, will be as wood. We pray, God, that you will change, God, things around. We pray, God, that you'll change the atmosphere. We pray, God, that you will turn things around. God, we pray that people may feel that they have gone a little higher. God, those that don't have hope, that they may begin to have hope. Those that have lost, God, their hope or their trust in you, we pray that it will be revived, that the gift of God may be stirred up in them this afternoon. Thank you for the things that you are doing, God, in this time. God, this day we dedicate it unto you. We thank you for the things that you have done and you
Hallelujah.
Will continue to do through us, God, because you aren't finished with us yet, God. This is just getting started. started. And whatever the enemy had intended for evil, God, you're going to make good out of it. Hallelujah. God, the situation that we're going through is only for a season. It's only temporal, God, but you will be glorified. You will prove yourself faithful, God, in the midst of whatever ache and pain, God, and disturbance, hallelujah, that the enemy is trying to bring against your people. We thank you, God, in advance for what you're doing even right now. We thank you for the visitation of the Holy Ghost. We thank you, God, for being with us. Hallelujah. We thank
hallelujah.
You for being right here as we can feel him even right now. Hallelujah. As we're getting started, God, to begin to share your word and to begin to, hallelujah, encourage ourselves and encourage others in the word today. Thank you, God, for the homes that have made it available to be able, God, to be used to spread your word. Thank you. I pray that you will anoint our lips, God, our ears to hear, as the book of Revelation says, he that had an ear, let him hear what the Spirit will have to say to the church. We are attentive, God, today to hear your Spirit, even though we have prepared ourselves, God, and we have made our notes, but we are
yes,
still
Lord. Hallelujah.
To what the Spirit of God will have to say. God, we're not bound, God, to a note on a piece of paper. God, we submit our members. We submit our minds. We submit our ears, we submit our whole being, God, to what the Spirit will have us to say today. I thank you, God, for what you're doing. I thank you, God, for the way you're moving right now. Those that will be connected, God, that you will put them right in tune with what's going on. That even though they may be connected in the middle or probably close to the end, that they may also be touched. Hallelujah. God, we pray for every hearer right now in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus, yes.
Still alive, hallelujah, and that you're seated at the right hand of the Father, that you're still interceding, hallelujah, and moreover, God, you're still answering prayers to everyone that believe on your name. I thank you and I honor you today in the mighty and prevailing name of Jesus. Thank you, God, for what you're doing. Thank you, God, for what you're doing. Thank you for the outreach, hallelujah. Thank you, God, for your extended hand. Thank you, God, for what you're doing for your people even right now.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I do believe, God, that you have begun to touch our minds. You have begun to touch our hearts. You have begun to touch our bodies. Thank you, God, for the open doors. Hallelujah. Everything that seems to be closed, we command and we declare and decree that there will be open doors that no man can shut. Hallelujah. We thank you, God, that you will teach us and lead us to go through those doors that you have opened. Hallelujah. And that we may understand and see where you're taking us and leading us. Hallelujah. For this last and end time outpouring in the mighty and prevailing name of Jesus, I pray today. Hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Thank
yes,
you,
Lord.
Hallelujah. Minister Orville.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Welcome, welcome, welcome. Welcome back to the new year. Our first episode, but our 150th episode, a celebration for Worth the Truth. Thank you,
Amen.
Jesus. It is a celebration, 150th episode. And welcome back, Sister Chrislyn. I miss
Yay!
You.
Oh, you. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Woo-hoo. Yes. I miss your smile.
Yes, oh, we God. Miss her yeah, so much.
It's so good to
God
see you.
God be the glory.
Oh, my God.
Man, it's good
it's
to see
so
you guys.
Good to see you.
You
likewise,
too, Brother Orville.
Thank God.
Hello, happy year to all of you.
Amen.
Yes, happy new year to all of you. God is good.
Happy new God's year, time. Yes.
We are bringing in the new year with a power-packed topic. It is the power of prayer. And tonight we are going to be talking about what is prayer. And prayer is different to everybody. So we're going to give our own little rendition on what is prayer. And we're going to get biblical, and we're going to give our own experiences on what is prayer for us. You know,
amen.
So first, amen. I want to introduce our Minister Orville Brown. He's
praise
our guest
Lord.
On tonight, so I thank God for him. Okay,
Amen.
wonderful prayer. Oh my God.
Yes, I
Yeah,
felt
thank
that
you.
thing.
Yes, I did too. Thank
Felt
God for that. And I
that
thank
thing.
God for our evangelist, Chrislyn Robinson. It is so good to see her. Oh my God, I have missed her so much. Been praying for her. So
Thank
thank
you.
God for her. And our mommy of the podcast, our evangelist, Astrid Brown. So
God
thank
bless everyone. Happy
Amen.
Monday. Happy New Year. Happy new level. We're going up from here. It can only be up.
Amen.
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 And I am Evangelist Julia Merced. So we are going to have an exciting podcast on tonight because
Yes. Brace yourselves.
you can't do prayer wrong. I'm sorry. Is no way to do prayer wrong. It is a power-packed message. It is a
Yes.
power-packed topic. So I thank God for prayer because everybody should be praying, especially in
Amen.
this day and time. We need to pray
Amen.
because it is praying time.
It is
If
sure
you are not
praying
praying,
time.
something is wrong with you
Come
because
on.
there is fire all around, I'm telling you. And when you got fire all around, you got to pray.
Yes. Amen.
Y'all got to stay out the fire. Just pray
Amen.
to stay out of that fire, boy. So, to God be the glory. So,
Amen.
tonight, our evangelist Astrid is going to head off the topic. I don't know if she's ready.
I am ready, ready,
Okay,
ready.
here we go. So,
I got time, the rest of the stuff. So I'm
okay.
just going to say thank God for just another day
Oh,
that
wait,
He
I
has
forgot to.
granted.
In our absence of Tawny
Tony.
Millard, I just forgot. We are going to miss her. She is taking the month off, and that's our little
Announcer.
hostess with the mostest, and she will not be
Yes.
here. So just keep her in your prayers, and we miss her today. So I had to mention my hostess with the mostest because she keeps us laughing, that child,
Yes.
too much. So
Amen.
go ahead, Sister Astrid. God bless you.
Okay, as I was preparing this week, this message for the power of prayer. We know that prayer is just interacting with God. It's just like communicating, having a communication. When you said you are in a relationship, whether it's romantic or just natural relationship, they have to be. You can't say somebody's your friend or somebody's your boo if there's no communication.
That's right.
Right? You can't have the relationship in your mind. You can't have say, I have a relationship with God, but you never communicate with him. The same way, like you can't say, I have a relationship with this woman or I have a relationship with this man, and but they're yet there's no communication. So it's just communicating with God, communicating in what format? You communicate with your thoughts, you communicate your emotions, you communicate your feelings, you communicate your desires, your wants, your goals, what you want to see happen in the future. I was listening the other day to Jamal Bryan, and he did an excerpt from Priscilla Shire and from a book that she wrote. And she said that when she prays, that she give God her plans, and at the end, and she prays over them. And at the end, she says, God, oh, what's better? What you know is better. Basically, like telling God, yes, I would like this. I would like this to happen in my life. But because you are the all-knowing God and the all-powerful God and the present God, what you know it's better. Like you can give me what I ask for, but give me what you know it's better. So
That's
that's
right.
what basically prayer is. Prayer is just having a communication. I was reading when I was a teenager in Honduras. I used to read a lot of books. Most of them was romantic, but anyway, I was reading this book And the book, the title of the book was Hey God. And it was about a girl that was a gangster, and she how she was in a woman's gang, and how she ended up meeting God in a very odd way. And her way of praying was, hey God. You know, so when she approached him for the very first time, she was like, hey God, if you're really real, I need you to do such and such and such. And God answered her prayer. And that became her phrase every time she approached God, hey God. So however we approach God, I know some people go in like really in a dogmatic way, like gracious Heavenly Father. Some other people pray, and I have heard where people have met God and they say, good morning, Jesus, or good evening, Jesus, good night, Jesus, you know, before they go to sleep. You know, however it is that you feel comfortable, because God didn't say, he, even though in the New Testament, he taught us how to pray. And, you know, our Heavenly Father, our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. You guys know the whole prayer. And some people still repeat it up to this day. And I was listening to a girl who was attacked by some people that she thought were friends of hers. And they turned out like really beating her to where she was almost beyond recognition. And she said that one thing, while she was on the floor and she was bleeding and she was all like, you know, that the first thing that she remembered as they were, this gang was like, of people were like beating on her and kicking her and spitting on her. She remembered the Lord's Prayer, and she started saying it, you know, whispering it. And she noticed that while she was saying the Lord's Prayer, that the people that was there was getting angry, and they were like, what are you doing? What are you doing? And like the spirits that were in them that was influencing them to do this to her started getting very grievous. And the police, all of a sudden the police came, and she don't know what happened, but she ended up in the hospital, and now she was telling the story. So prayer is just a way of us connecting with God. And through his finished work on the cross, he has allowed us to have that access. He has granted us to have that access to come into the Holy of Holies, or his, or the presence of God. We praying is petitioning, you know, bringing God our petitions, bringing God thanksgiving, is communicating with God by praising him, confessing our sins before him, in communion with the Creator. When we pray, we engage in a loving fellowship with the Maker of heaven and earth. It's a sense of privilege, giving at being his children. We have been giving because of his finished work on the cross. There is a song that I used to sing back home, and I had to like look up the lyrics, part of the lyrics, because I couldn't remember the whole thing. But the song says, oh, what joy divine, I can feel the current moving on the line. Made by God the Father for his very own, you may talk to Jesus on this royal telephone. And the songs, and it's made by Jimmy Little, and it's called Royal Telephone. It says Central is never busy. It's always on the line. You can hear from heaven almost anytime. It is a royal service. It's built for one and for all. Whenever you get in trouble, give this royal line a call. Amen. And then it says, there will be no charges. This telephone line is free. It was built for service, just for you and for me. There will be no waiting. On this royal line, this telephone to glory always answers just in time. Prayer is essential to the believers. We are commanded by God to pray continuously as we seek and grow in intimacy with Him. And I'm going to put up all the scriptures that I have. I'm going to write them up as my other colleagues are speaking, expounding on the word. Jesus prayed intentionally, and he was very disciplined. He was very disciplined in praying. He always prayed to the Heavenly Father. I have 10 reasons why we should pray. One, God called us to pray, right? Second, Jesus prioritized prayer. The third one, our Heavenly Father rewards us when we pray. And one of my favorite scriptures is Mark 11 and 24, I think it is. Whatsoever thing you desire, when you pray, believe, the Bible says, and you shall have it. Amen. So our Heavenly Father does reward us when we pray. Prayer strengthens us against temptations. When we pray, we can endure hardness as a good soldier. When we pray, we can flee youthful lust. Amen. God uses our prayers to accomplish also his will. Because sometimes it's through trials and tribulations that makes us go into fervent prayer before God, because we are in trouble and we are afflicted. And sometimes God allows these things to happen. Not that he does them, but he allows it to happen sometimes, so we can turn to the Father and ask for help. So number six, prayer is powerful and prayer is effective. Amen. The Bible says the effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. So don't ever think that because sometimes the answers are prolonged that God didn't hear us. God said he will hear us when we call. And that's in Jeremiah 33 and 3. And it says, call unto me and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things which thou knewest not. Number seven, prayer gives God all the glory. When you pray, it's because you made a conscious decision that you are going to allow God to be the pilot on your plane. Basically, you're saying, God, I'm praying and I'm just presenting, because his word says also in 1 Peter chapter 5, cast all your cares upon him, for he cares for you. So prayer is utilized also to be able to cast all our cares, our concerns, our burdens upon the Lord. Amen. Chapter 8, prayer help us receive and give also forgiveness. Through the forgiveness of Jesus Christ, we can be able to forgive ourselves, and also through his forgiveness, we can be able to forgive ourselves and also forgive others. Number nine, prayer reveals the sufficiency of God's grace. It's only through prayer that when we locked in, like I said, on that royal telephone, that you don't have to wait and you don't have to pay for it. It's free. It's a free vehicle straight up to the throne of grace, straight up to God. When we pray, God will reveal sometimes through prayer. I remember one time that I was praying and God was answering me through the prayer. I can hear the answer right where I was praying. Like God was giving me the answer right back. So there's times that God would do that. And prayer keeps us thankful. But when we pray, we walk in admiration and we walk in we glorify his sovereignty, and we just say, God, I just thank you. When we think of, like the song say, when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he's done for me, My soul cries out, hallelujah. I thank God for saving me. So sometimes when we are praying, God reminds us of his goodness. He brings us back to a memory. You know, sometimes we find ourselves in situations where we feel despair and we feel like giving up. And just by praying and crying out to God, our strength is renewed and our faith is made stronger. Amen. So what is prayer? Prayer is just communicating. It's just communicating with God. It's just developing that friendship and that relationship. Like I said, you know, as is in the natural, so it is in the spiritual. Develop a friendship with Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
It's like it says it's a divine, it's a divine fellowship. Amen. Amen. So I am done and I'm gonna write the scriptures that I have tonight on the comment section, if anybody want to like go through them afterwards. And I'm going to hand it over because she hasn't been here in a while,
Mr. Christmas.
To Evangelist Robinson. What is prayer to you?
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
God bless you. Sister Ashridge, you really covered most of it. It's not like a broad scope of things, but I just want to give you a few of the definitions of prayer that encapsulates what Sister Evangelist Astrid said. According to Wikipedia, prayer is an invocation or an act that seeks to activate a rapport with an object of worship through deliberate communication. Britannica Dictionary, an act of communication by humans with the sacred or holy God, God of gods, the transcendent realm, or supernatural powers. Dictionary.com, a spiritual communication with God or an object of worship, as in a supplication, thanksgiving, adoration, or confession. It could also mean to judge. Understanding prayer fully, I think it's also important that we understand what it means, what supplication means, what does invocation mean, and what Amen. Does intercession mean. In the simplest form, it's just like Sister Astrid said, it's a communication. You're communicating with for us, it is the Most High God, the true and living God, the creator of all things, the Alpha, the Omega. It's our way of having a conversation with God. And a conversation is two-way. You pray to God and God gives you back the answer. The answer is always lining up with God's word because God never separates himself from his word. So we pray God's word to him and God gives us the answer through his word. And so, yes, prayer is a conversation. And in those conversations, you get to know God. You begin to develop a relationship with him. Because listen, if we were all to tell the truth, when we first got saved, none of us knew how to pray. It's like the young lady, Sister Astrid, was talking about, and she was like, hey, God, you know.
Yes.
That was her way of, you know, talking to God from the beginning. It was what she knew. And
yes.
Developing a relationship, she stayed along those lines. And the Bible teaches us, you know, how to pray, Our Father. Or we have the spirit of adoption, wherefore we cry, Our Father or Father. And so, you develop a relationship with God, rapport with God, and it's just simply asking, invoking.
Yes.
When you want somebody to do something for you, they're not mind readers. They don't automatically know what it is that you want. You have to ask for it. And that's what we do. We pray and we ask God for whatever it is that we feel that we need. But I think that prayer goes a lot deeper because Before we pray, now we know that some of our prayers are urgent, they're emergencies, but before we get into that space, we tell the Lord how much we love him. We worship him. We tell him we adore him. We lift up his name. We begin to talk to the Lord as if he is our a father, just like a person, not just some entity that we don't understand or we don't know. When we say our father, we really mean from our gut, from our spirit, our father.
Our
And when
father.
you think about the role of a father, a role of a father is to protect you, to love you, to help you, to support you, to pick you up, to encourage you, whatever that is, to fulfill your needs. A father is there in so many different roles and spaces. So when we are having those conversations with God, we're talking to him and we're calling him and we're calling upon him. We want him to know that we depend on him, that we trust him, that we need him, that we can't do anything without him, and that he is our source. And I think that when we talk about, as in the, I think it's in Luke, Matthew, the sixth chapter, our Father, as Asher was saying, our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. And when that prayer starts out, it is our Father, which art in heaven, because God's throne is above us, and God is above us all, and God is above everything. So our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. God's name is holy. It's not just a name you throw around. It's a holy name. And so hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come on earth as it is in heaven. Father, let my prayer be aligned with your will,
Come
with your
on.
word. So when you say, or when we say, or when the scripture says, let it be done on earth as it is in heaven. So what is it that is going on in heaven that we want to happen in earth? And God's word says that. You just gotta know the word of God. So when I pray to God for my well-being, for my health, God's word says, I will above all, beloved. He says, beloved, I wish above all that thou would prosper and be
And
in
be in
health,
hell.
even as thy
Amen.
soul prospers. So it's God's will that I be in good health and that I prosper. And on the other side of that, I say, Father, you said in your word that no weapon that's formed against the righteous shall prosper. And every tongue that shall rise up against me in judgment, thou shalt condemn. For this is what the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their righteousness is of me, saith the Lord. That's God's word. When God's word says that not even one sparrow falls to the ground that God does not know, how much more my heavenly Father knows about me? So whatever God's word said, that's what we give back to God in our prayer. So prayer is a way of conversating with God. It's a way of getting to know God. It's also a way of building ourselves, as Astrid says. I think it's Jude 1 and 20 says, beloved, that you build up. Let
Your
me go.
most
Let me go
holy
to the
faith,
scripture.
yes.
How it says, but ye beloved, building up yourselves in your most holy faith, praying in
Yes,
the Holy Ghost. I
in
think the
the Holy
scriptures
Ghost,
also
yes.
says that we know not how we should pray as we ought to, but the Spirit itself gives us, it ushers us or unctions us, that and tells us what we should pray for. Because sometimes, we pray for what we feel like we need or what we want or what we desire. But is it what God desires for us? When you're praying in the Holy Spirit, God gives you that unction of what to pray for, because God knows what we have need of. But in
Amen.
prayer, you want to invoke God to do something. And the way to get God to invoke God to do something is to give him back his word. Father, you said in your word, X, Y, and
Amen.
Z. But the more you pray, the more you build up your faith, the more you build up your strength, the more resistant you become to the things of the world, the things of the flesh. Because the scriptures states, I think it's also in Romans 8 chapter, that we walk not in the flesh, But we walk in the spirit, and the way to walk in the spirit is that we build up ourselves in the way of prayer and in the way of learning God's word. We build ourselves. How do you combat whatever it is that's going on in your life? And I was just saying this to myself the other day. I was saying, if the weapons of our warfare are not carnal but mighty through God, to the pulling down of strongholds, casting down imaginations, then what tools, what weapons are we using according to God's word to be able to do that? So, in order for us to be able to cast down those imaginations, in order for us to put on the whole armor of God, in order for us to be able to war in the spirit, in order for us to be able to ask God to release the prayers that may have been held up for 21 days, we got to dig into the word of God. So just simply put, as Ashua says, prayer is not rocket science. It is not, it's extremely simple. The reality of it is that you know the God that you serve. You know
Amen.
God's will for our life because he spelled it out for us in the scriptures. It is God's will that we be safe. It is God's will that we be protected. It is God's will that we be healthy. It's God's will that we have seed. It is God's will that we have bread. It is God's will that we be fruitful and multiply. It is God's will that our household be saved. And when we are praying, we pray those things back to God. Father, according to your will. And so those are just things that, just a list of things that, when you're talking to God, those are things that you're praying for. I think the most beautiful prayer that I've ever read in scripture is Second Chronicles, the sixth chapter, the prayer of Solomon. And the prayer simply states that if we turn to this place, because he was relating to the temple, if we pray in this place, if we pray toward this place, he's
Yes.
asking God to hear our prayer. Not only us, but people that are not like us, or people that are not worried at those, Hebrew, that they weren't of the children of Israel. If someone came into the sheepfold and they prayed towards this place, hear our prayer. Not just our prayer for what we need, not just an intercessory prayer for the people that we love, but if we pray towards this place, if we sin and we pray towards this place, we ask for you to forgive us, Father. So prayer is encapsulates whatever it is that you're in that moment that you need God to answer. I don't know what it may be for you, but whenever you bow your knees, there is a prayer that we pray. We automatically pray for the saints. Number one,
Amen.
when we bow our knees, we automatically are going to pray one for another. We're automatically going to pray for our families. We're automatically going to pray for the families of the people of God. We're automatically going to pray for healing and the health of God's people. We're automatically going to pray for the fulfilling of the needs of your people. We're automatically going to pray, Father, protect us and keep us, establish our going out and our coming in again. We're
Yeah.
automatically going to ask God and invoke him to answer those prayers. So simply put, it's a conversation.
Yes.
I'm asking you, Father, and I'm humbly asking you because I know I can't do anything without you. And Father, in my prayers, I say, Father, I've went to all of the resources in this world, but you're the source.
You are the
A
source.
thousand
Amen.
cattle upon a hill belong to you. So at the end
Yes.
of the day, it doesn't matter whatever sources or resources I have, God is my ultimate source and I depend on him. We could trust in horses, we could trust in chariots, but I call upon the name of the Lord.
You
And
will
that's what I do
remember.
in my prayer. I call upon the name of the Lord. So prayer is an
Yes.
invocation. It is to asking God to do something, but it's also to tell God how much we love him and how much we adore him and how much we need him and how much we depend on him.
Yes.
And God looks for that because the scripture says, I think it's in St. John 4:4. The scripture says the Father is looking for true worshipers
Come on.
and to worship him in spirit and in truth.
And true.
And the
Yes.
first line of prayer is worship.
It's
And
worship. Yes.
Jesus Christ himself said it. Our Father, which art in heaven. The first order of prayer is worship. It
Worship.
is worship. Worship God for whom He is, not for what He can do and what He can give. But I first worship you, Father, for who you are, because I know everything else comes under that umbrella. If I
Amen.
worship you for who you are, I know you're a healer. I know you're a
Yes,
deliverer.
you're a
I know
deliverer.
you are a
Yes,
keeper.
God.
I know you are a provider. I know you are Jehovah Sabaoth, the Lord of hosts. I know you can fight my battles. I know you are my peace. I know you are my righteousness. I know you're all those things because I worship you as the Most High God. So prayer is a beautiful thing. It is one of the most wonderful tools in an arsenal for any believer, prayer, because prayer gives you an opportunity to talk to God and for God to talk back to you. It is an
Amen.
opportunity to worship Him. It's an opportunity to expect an answer from Him. It's an opportunity to give God the chance to show up in your life mighty and strong,
Yes.
no matter what
Amen.
the battle is, because
Yes.
there are many battles that are fought in the name of the Lord. And if God is who He says He is to us, even though it looks like the enemy may be winning in whatever level, whether it's our finances, whether it's our health, whether he's coming up against our mind, whatever he's built or whatever walls he's built, there it is in God's word. And God has been there to answer every single battle. The only thing that turns God or stops God is that we're living a life of untruthfulness.
Yes. Amen.
Because the Bible says if we regard iniquity in our heart, God will not hear us. And so we cannot hold sin and iniquity in our heart. That's why, as Astrid said, forgiveness. Amen. The Bible declares that when you stand, when you
And
pray
you
and
pray.
forgive. And when you stand, you have to stand in that forgiveness. You can't walk around holding on to harboring things in your heart for people and
Yes.
expect God to forgive you when you ask Him for forgiveness. That's also in the Lord's Prayer. Forgive us of our trespasses
Our
as we forgive those
trespasses
who
as we,
trespassed against us.
yes.
That's
Come
why that
on.
particular prayer is a roadmap. It's a pattern
That's
for
right.
us to follow. And
That's right.
even if we don't say that prayer verbatim, there are so many scriptures that line up with that prayer verbatim. And
Yes.
so we have to know that we have to follow that pattern. There's only one pattern in the scriptures, and it's all lined up in God's word.
Amen.
So that's my take on prayer. Prayer is just simply it's a wide range, but in its simplest form, it's just communication.
It's just
Astrid was talking
communication.
about her song. We had that song, Jesus on the Main Line. Tell them
Tell
what
him
you
what you want.
want. Jesus
Yes.
on the Main Line. Yes, yes, yes. And I think it's
Call him up. Call him up.
yes,
Tell him
call him
what
up,
you
tell him what
want.
you want. But
Come
there's also
on.
this song that came to my heart. Brother Orwell sings, You must have. I love that
The
song.
power
The
of the
Holy
Holy
Ghost, that
Ghost.
prayer will
Yes.
turn it.
Prayer
Keep
will
that
turn it.
fire
Keep that
burning.
fire
Make you
burning.
scream
Yes.
out, make you cry
Kind of.
because it's real. Well,
Yeah.
I put my hand in the master's hand. I love
Yes.
that song because
Yes.
you must have the
The
Holy
power of
Ghost.
the
It
Holy
gets that
Ghost.
prayer
Yes.
wheel turning and it
Yes.
keeps the
Keeps
fire
the fire
burning.
burning. Yes.
Hallelujah. Thank you,
And pray.
Jesus.
Yes. Prayer
That's a
mixed with
beautiful
faith.
song.
It's
Yes, yes, yes,
unstoppable.
yes, 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 yes. And
But
that's
we
why I
are,
love it. It helps you
yes,
to build up on your most holy
your
faith.
most holy faith.
Builds,
Yes.
builds. The reason why we become resilient is because we build. We started with
Amen.
one prayer and we built up an altar on our
Yes,
hearts
come
for the Lord.
on.
And so
Yes.
we can come and pray. We built that altar. We come there and we sacrifice to God for
Yes.
what we want God to do in our lives. So I'm gonna stop there because you could talk about prayer forever because there's
Forever,
so much
yes. Say
involved in
that,
prayer.
yes. Praise the
And
Lord, hallelujah.
it is our
So
number
we're
one
gonna
tool.
continue. Irville, I don't know if you want to go next, or Sister Julie, you want to go next?
Can wrap it up because, like Sister Kristen was saying, a whole lot has been shared. I'm just blessed by hearing and just underlining some things I have written here because I'm like, okay, I do want to be repetitive on some of the things that has been said. I think I can start out saying and underlining the fact that prayer is a communication. For communication to be held, there must be a speaker, a message, and a receptor or a receiver of the message. And then
Amen.
we have the turning around
That's
of
my brother, y'all. That's my brother. My blood
then we
brother.
have a turning around a position where the speaker becomes the receiver and the receiver becomes the speaker and gives the message. So prayer is a form of communication between humanity. It just blows our mind to know that an almighty God, a God that created the heaven and earth, will find a way for humanity to communicate for him, to give us the opportunity to tell him our concerns, our worries, our requests, and our praises. Now, when we talk about prayer, sometimes we think that it's only like words or communicating with words, but we can communicate in prayer by praising him. When
Come
we begin
on.
to praise God, we are also praying to him. We are adoring him. We are telling him how high and special he is. Another
Majestic.
way of communicating with God is confessing our faults or our trespasses or our sins to him, when we can become sincere, because the effective prayer involves being sincere from the heart. Now,
Amen.
there are a lot of people that try to impress God with these 10-syllable words or these profound and what we call 2-pound words, but God is looking for a contrite and a broken heart.
Come
Hallelujah.
on.
Bible say that he will not despise a broken and a contrite heart.
Amen.
So it's not the amount of words, there's a word that comes from
It's
your heart
right.
when you can just sit down or you can stand up or you can prostrate before his presence and say, God,
Yes.
I love you. In your own words, express to him how you feel and make your request be known unto
Unto
God.
God,
And not
yes.
only making your request known, but when there is a communication or a conversation, trust me, he will answer you back. Hallelujah. If you have an ear to hear what the Spirit will have to say, when you begin to read his word, God speaks to you. He speaks to you through songs. He speaks to you through
Amen.
testimony. He speaks to you in diverse forms, but we gotta be ready to hear what he will have to say.
Come
I just
on.
want to put a little testimony in there. Before the year 2023 was over, I sat on my bed and as I was speaking to my wife, I said, I have something on my shoulders that I need God to speak to me about. I said, and I'm not waiting until 2024 to kick in. I'm waiting for God now in 2023 because the same God that can answer me in 2024 has the power to answer me in
Answer me,
2023.
amen.
Hallelujah. Little did I know that Sunday when I went to church, I just began to worship and I just began to thank God. The same
Thank you,
exact thing
Jesus.
that I was saying to God, God, I need to know if you're going to make this certain thing come through in my life. God, I need an answer. And in my prayer, Sister Chrislyn, I was saying to God, God, if this miracle does not occur in my life, I'll still worship you because I
Amen.
know you have the power. I said, God,
Hallelujah.
if this thing doesn't come through, if I don't get the desires of my heart, that won't change my
That's
worship. It
right.
won't change my praise because I've learned to trust you, and I've learned to worship you for who you are, not for what you give me. So I say, God, it won't change anything in my worship. It won't change anything in my praise, but I just need to know if this is your will or if not your will. That Sunday morning while sitting in church, hallelujah, the bishop came down from the pulpit and went straight to my seat, and he said, thus saith the Lord, that whatever he promised to you and whatever he said he was going to do, God's going to do it in this year, 2024. That
Come
was
on.
Hallelujah. And
yes.
It's serious for me to know that God is still listening. I'm not talking about a God that was spoken of in the Old Testament or 2,000 years ago. I'm talking about a God that is still answering prayer today. Hallelujah. Power in prayer. I still believe that when you're broke, you break your heart. I still believe when your heart is contrite, that sometimes you don't know what word to say. Sometimes you can
just groan it.
Because sometimes God knows, hallelujah, every tear. God knows every gesture. You don't have to look for pretty words to communicate.
That's right.
And God, all you have to do is to speak from the bottom of your heart. And God has an ear to hear and a mouth to speak, hallelujah. I believe that God is about to answer somebody on this podcast tonight. I believe that you need to be encouraged that whatever he's promised, he's not a man to lie, not a son of man to repent. If
Come
God
on.
Said it, God's going to bring it.
It's going to happen. It's going to happen.
I don't know if you're feeling something today, but I'm encouraged this podcast tonight. Hallelujah. Philippians 4:6 says, do not be anxious about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication.
Let your requests
let your request be known to God. Hallelujah. Don't only bring your request, but thank him for the thing.
Thank you, Jesus. Yes.
With supplication, prayer and supplication and thanksgiving. You know, sometimes we think and we look at God as if he was an errand boy. God, give me this, do this for me, do the other for me, but we forget to thank
Jesus.
Him for the hallelujah, for the air that we breathe. Thank you for the job that I have.
Thank you,
thank
Lord
you
Jesus.
For the children
thank
that you've
God.
Given me. God, and when you begin to thank him, you can feel your spirit just
thank
begin
you,
to be energized, and you just begin to continue to worship. Sometimes it's the Christian, we forget the things that we were about to ask God when we begin to thank him. And then we wonder, oh my God. And then we begin to understand that God knows your need before you even
you
ask. And he
Come on.
Will answer you before you even ask. So I think
That's
we should take a little more time to just thank him. Oh God, I thank you this day for your presence.
Thank
I
you,
thank
Jesus.
You, God, for covering me. I thank you the bed that you make me to lay down on.
Jesus.
God, in the good time and in the bad time, we have to learn to thank the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Lord,
thank
hallelujah.
You,
thank you, Jesus.
I'm in there with to be content. Sometimes I don't know where the money is coming from, but I know that he said in his word, I've never seen the righteous forsaken or his seed.
Nor his seed.
I feel like testifying again, and you'll have to excuse me for getting a little excited on this
That's
podcast.
All right.
December 31st, God is my witness. Oh my goodness. I didn't, like the song say, I didn't have a dime in my pocket. But I went to the service, Sister Julia, and I said, God, I'll still worship you anyhow.
That's right.
When I got to the church and I walked in, Sister Astrid, somebody called me and he said, somebody sent you this money from United States. Oh my.
Wow. God.
Hallelujah.
Won't he do it? Won't he do it?
It wasn't who I expected to. Because this is another thing I'm learning in the day and time that we're living in.
Right.
God's going to come through an alley that you were not expecting.
Not expect.
You see,
That's
God will
why,
not show his
yes, he
glory
will.
to man, and you will know that it
Yes,
was
Lord, yes,
God
he will. See that?
who you're
That's right.
expecting your answer to come through. God is not going to sell it that way.
You better
He's going
talk
to
about
sell
it.
it through a way that you are not expecting. All you got to do is pray and believe. Let me go a little forward. I need to just skip through what I have right here. Four basic forms of prayer. Sometimes we feel like, oh, well, there's only one position and only one way to prayer. But there's a prayer of blessing and adoration. And I'm going to make echo to Sister Chrisling's words in Matthew 6, 9 to 13. We all know that scripture about the Lord's Prayer. Prayer of blessing and adoration. Jesus gave us the example. Look at the way he started to pray. Our
That's right.
Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And then I classify it in a prayer of petition. After you have acknowledged who he is, after you have praised him for a little while, then you can place your position. Petition, and we ask God for what we need, and we also include asking Him to forgive us. In His prayer, after He said that, He said, "Give us this day our daily bread,
Yes,
and
yes.
forgive us our debts, or our trespasses, or our sins, whatever you want to call it, as we forgive our debtors, or those that trespass against us." And then we can say there is a prayer of intercession, asking for what others need, not necessarily yourself. You can also include yourself when he said, "Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." And then we go back to the prayer of thanksgiving for what God has given and has done. For thine is the kingdom and
Yes.
the power and the
Yes.
glory
Yes.
forever. And Jesus concluded his prayer right there. How did Jesus define prayer? He said that prayer should be a private time between God and the worshiper. Jesus does not
Yes.
mean that it is wrong to pray with others, but the prayers should be sincere and for the right motives. I
Amen.
want you
Come
to
on, say
get
that
here.
again. The
Your
right
prayer
motives.
ought to be sincere and for the right motives, if you want. Oh, I'm going
Amen.
into next week's podcast, but it has to be sincere and it has to be for the right motives.
Yes, not
How does
amiss.
God say that we should pray? And I'm coming to an end. When you pray, go into a room, close the door, and pray to your
Yes.
Father who is unseen or in secret. Then your Father who sees what is done in secret will reward you, how the Bible says.
Openly.
Openly.
Openly. And when you pray, do not keep on babbling like pagans, for they think they will be heard because of their many words.
Yes.
Remember, I said to you, it has to be sincere, because we cannot impress God. God knows who you are. God knows
Amen.
who we
Come
are.
on, say that again.
Just make it real. You know, don't
That's
try
right.
to pretend, or don't try to look big when
Yes.
you're praying. Just say it as you feel it. You know, God understands, and He knows that it's coming from the depths of your heart. God tells us to pray, although prayer can and should be done from any bodily position. The Bible lists five specific postures, and I'm finishing with these postures. Number one, you can pray sitting down. Hallelujah. 2 Samuel 7, 18
Yes.
says, "Then went David in and sat before the Lord, and he made his request known. He was sitting," according to 2 Samuel 7, 18. Then it says, "And when you stand praying," so that's telling me that another position for you to pray is standing. He said, "Forgive if you have an ought against any that your Father, which is in heaven, will forgive you. So it's important for an effective prayer for you to forgive. Sometimes we forget that we're carrying or harboring in our heart things that are not pleasing to God. That's the reason why when we start praying, Sister Christine, you have to say, like David says, search me and see.
Yes, my favorite scripture.
Hallelujah. I think this is a time for us to ask God to search us from the inside out.
Inside out.
Sometimes we try to blame the devil and we try to blame the church and we try to blame the neighbor and we say, well, this one isn't living right and the other one isn't living right. But when you take the time and you say, create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew my spirit within me, and cast me not away from your presence, and take not the Holy Ghost from me, but restore unto me the joy of your salvation. You'll see things differently. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. The next thing, according to Daniel 6:7, when Daniel knew that the writing was signed, he went into his house, and his window being open towards Jerusalem, the Bible say he kneeled. So another position is kneeling before the Lord. I spoke to you about sitting. I spoke to you about standing. And I spoke to you about
kneeling.
And then another place and another way to prostrate or to pray to God is with the face to the ground. According to Mark 14:35, when Jesus was led to the Garden of Gethsemane, the Bible says he fell on the ground. And he said, Lord, let not this cup be passed from me. Nevertheless, not my will, but thy
will be done.
Yes.
How do you pray according to God? Number one, know to whom you are speaking. I think, oh my goodness, sometimes we tend to forget as human who we are addressing. When you start thinking of the God that said, let it be, and it was done. The God that spoke and everything that he spoke to just came in existence. When you realize the his power, when you realize how great he is, how
awesomeness
awesome God is, and you begin to want a phantom in this little mind who God really is, then your approach in praying will change when you have a perception of who you are speaking to.
Thank you, Jesus.
Number two, we have to learn to thank him. Thank him. Thank him for the good times. Thank him for the bad times. In whatever state we're in, there is something God wants to do.
Yes.
Sometimes we go through and some processes seems a little longer than others is because we have not learned what the Spirit of God want to teach us through the situation that we're facing. You got to understand that weeping in these difficult situations endure but for a moment. Hallelujah.
Yes, it will come.
Joy will come in the morning. Number three, in closing, ask God according, as Sister Christian was saying, according to his will. And for you to ask God according to his will, you need to know his word. Study the word to show yourself approved. When you know the word, then you will be able to pray according to the word. Say what you need. Be specific. Sometime it calls my attention.
Amen.
When he said to the man, will thou be made whole?
Yes.
That was a yes or no question.
That's right.
Wasn't
Baby
it?
Jesus.
But Sister Kristen, they asked a simple, Jesus said to the man, will thou be made whole?
Do you want to?
Do you want to be made whole?
Yes. In other words, you want to be made whole.
And then he said, sir, all he had to say, yes. And he would have received his healing. But he went on with his little story, sir, I have no man when the water is stirred to take me into the pool, because while I am coming, another step. And Jesus
Another
did not
step
ask him
faith.
that. He did not say, relate your situation. Because when you read the scripture, Sister Astrid, it says, and God knowing the position and where the man was in, God already knew how long he was there. God already knew what he had to go through. All he said to them, do you want to be whole?
That's right.
Do you want to
Come
be
on.
And it was a simple answer right there that he was supposed to go. But then he said to him, rise, take up thy bed.
Take your bed up.
So be specific.
And go on.
Be specific and let God know what you're asking him for.
Amen.
While you're praying, always ask for forgiveness. Because
Thank
there
you,
are some things that we may be conscious of and some things
knowing
we
or unbeknowingly.
Or we have
Yes.
forgotten. You know, sometimes we're like Zacchaeus when he said, if I have sinned, but we're going to leave that right there. If I have done wrong. Okay.
If.
Oh my goodness. The next item will be
he knew well.
The word.
Thank you, Lord.
Sister Christie was saying that, pray according to the word. And we do that by memorizing the scripture.
Now,
there's so much, like Sister Kristen was saying, and my sister Astrid, that we can say about prayer. But remember, when you kneel down, stand up, sit down, prostrate, whatever, lay down and pray, you know, don't only speak to God because he wants to speak back to you. If you had forgotten everything I said, he's not a God, only a recipient, but he's also a transmitter, someone who can also speak back to you.
That's right.
You will hear him. He's speaking now
louder
and clearer than ever. If you have an ear, just hear what the Spirit will have to say. God bless you today.
Amen.
Ooh.
Amen.
Like the scripture said, then our hearts burn. I don't know about you, but mine was burned.
Yes.
Anyway. I'm going to give Sister Julia space now so she can expand on this. And I know, Sister Chrislyn, you have to leave. So whenever you're ready, my sister, you are dismissed in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We thank you for
God
coming
you.
On
was
tonight.
So good to see you,
we're
sister.
So good to see
likewise,
you again and to
lovely.
hear you
Okay.
And to hear you expand on the word
Yes.
of the Lord. So,
Amen.
You know, lately, like we've been going over past a little bit 8 o'clock, but it's because the lessons has been so
So good.
intense and our heart has been fervently, you know, passionate about, you know, doing the work of the Lord. And this is 2004. This is our first opening and you already see how it's going. So,
amen,
amen. Amen, Sister Julia, go right ahead.
As long as I can listen to Sister Julia.
Okay, Sister Julie.
Just like everybody was saying, prayer is communication. Mm-hmm. Communication between you and God, but it's honest communication.
Amen.
Because you can't lie in your prayer. How are you going to lie and pray? You can't do it. You got to be honest. It
Come
is
on.
Honest communication between you and God.
Yes.
Prayer is not just talking to God. It is him talking back to you because no one carries on a conversation without receiving something back.
Yes, come on.
How do you develop a relationship? That's part of talking, praying, developing relationship. And I love what Sister Evangelist Kristen said. She said, it is a chance for God to show up in your life.
Come
How
on.
Do you know God is not going to show up if you don't listen? So many people just want to pray, get it out the way, and say they prayed. But did you listen?
That's so
did
true.
You listen
did
for
you took
direction?
Time to listen? Yes. Yes,
we need
yes,
direction.
Yes.
We need direction when we pray. Why? Because we need to be able to make sound decisions.
Come on.
How do we know we're going to make the right decision if we're not listening for God's voice to direct us? Well, how? And she said we got to pray the word. If you don't know the word, you can't pray the word.
Come on.
First thing you do when you pray, you're supposed to get your Bible. You get your Bible, you open up to a scripture. I don't care if it's one verse.
That's
You
right.
get your Bible, you open it up. Lord, speak to me. He will
Yes.
speak to you through his word. And you open it up. You may not know what it means. Get an amplified Bible. It's plain English. Get something you can understand. Open it up. Lord, just speak to me. Give me one word. I need a word for today.
Yes.
It says in the prayer, it says he will give you this day your daily bread.
Amen.
What is daily bread but something you can feed on? Something you need for nourishment. He will
sustenance,
give you your
yes.
daily bread every day.
Amen.
But first, you got to learn how to worship. It says, Heavenly Father. It says, Our Father. It says, pray, Father, hallowed be thy name. It says, you know why it says, hallowed be thy name? You can't go to God with just any old thing. In Ecclesiastes, it says, keep thy foot. Ecclesiastes 5, it says, keep thy foot when thou goest to the house of God, and be more ready to hear than to give sacrifice of fools, for they consider not that they do evil. We all make mistakes.
Yes, we do.
Be not rash with thy mouth, but let thine heart let not thine heart be hasty to utter anything before God.
Amen.
You can't just say anything before God. You got to be conscious of what you're telling. That's why you got to be honest.
Amen.
Because you know why? God knows your heart.
Yes,
he knows. That's why, you know, when it says, he said, be sincere and have the right motive. Minister Orville said, be sincere and have the right motive. You know what? The first thing you got to say is, Lord, search me. Know
yes.
who I am.
Turn on
when
the
you
spot.
Come to prayer, that should be your prayer. Every time.
Thank
Lord,
you,
if I'm coming to you any which way and it's not pleasing, search me. Clean my heart. Sometimes we come and we have so many different things going on in our life. We need God to purge us.
Blood.
So that our prayer
Blood
will go up. That's why it says we pray amiss. Because why? We're praying after our own love.
Come on.
We're praying after
come
our
on.
Own desires.
I was waiting for
we're
that
praying
word.
After our own things. We
yep.
can't come to God with any old thing. God will
lust
say,
of
I
the
can't
eyes
hear
and lust
you.
of the flesh.
He's going to be like, talk to my hand because I don't hear you. You don't want to hear that. He wants a clean heart.
Amen.
He said, only he that has a clean heart and pure hands.
And pure hands.
To him.
Yes.
Pure heart and clean hands.
Yeah. You can't come to God with that. You got to have a pure heart. You got to know your motives when you come
Thank
to
you,
God.
Jesus.
And you know how you come into him. You come into him. Oh, well, I know Sister So-and-so did me wrong. That's all right. But I'm still going to come and pray. No, you go to Sister So-and-so, sister, and make it right.
Amen.
Make it right.
Amen.
You know why? Because love covers a multitude of sins.
Yes, it does, my dear sister.
Love covers a multitude of sins. He's covering yours.
Amen.
When he died on the cross, he covered every one of your sins. So how could you come and be holding grudges and this, that, and the other and expect your prayer to be answered? It doesn't work that way. That's why we got to tell the Lord, Lord, search me and know me. Know my heart, Lord. If I'm going to come to you and I'm going to come to you, I want to come to you right. I want to come to you in a way that you can be pleased so
yes,
that
so my
prayer can be answered.
Yes, it won't be hindered. Yes.
Because you don't want your prayer to just reach the ceiling and fall down to the ground. Because that's the way we have different patterns for prayer. Minister Orwell said sitting, standing, kneeling, laying prostrate. These are different prostrates of prayer. But it matters how you present
All
that
right, sis. All
prayer.
right.
Yes.
I don't care how you come, but it matters how your heart is
Yes.
in the motive of your heart.
Yes.
If your heart is not pure, that prayer ain't going nowhere.
Come on.
A
Amen.
pure heart and clean hands. Let me tell you something. There are so many people that come to God with dirty hands, and you'd be like, man, why they don't move like they used to? Why they're not doing like they used to? Why there's no
Yes.
power here? Why there's no power there? You know what? Let me tell you something.
All
When you
right,
go to
Sister
church
Julia.
and you can get an answer, Lord, I need an answer right here, right now.
Come on.
That's because your heart is right with God. You
Thank
know
you.
why Minister Orville can go to church and say, Lord, I need an answer right here, right now. I can't wait until 2024. I needed my answer right then, right there. I remember when my daughter was missing and I didn't hear from her for almost 5 days. And I said, Lord, I can't take it no more. I said, I need to hear from her before 12 o'clock. By 11 o'clock, I was sitting in the parking lot and my phone rang. It was my daughter. And I, it
Praise the
was me
Lord.
and God in my bedroom. And I said, Lord, I've had enough. I said, I need to hear from my baby. I said, I don't know where she's at, whether she's dead or alive, but I don't feel like she's dead. But I
My
need to hear her
voices.
voice.
Ooh, that's powerful.
And
Yes.
let me tell you something. I said, Lord, I give you to 12 o'clock,
Thank you,
11
Jesus.
o'clock on the dot. I was sitting in the parking lot of ShopRite supermarket and my phone rang because I couldn't even go into the store to go shopping and my husband didn't want to leave me in the house. And I said, babe, I can't even go inside. I just want to sit right here. I'll sit right here. And I sat right there and I held that. When I heard the phone ring and I saw it was unknown, I just picked it up and I heard my baby's voice and the tears just fell down my face.
Jesus.
Let me tell you something. You gotta live right. Because
Yes.
God will answer your prayer right there on the spot.
Come on.
But it depends on the prostrate of your heart.
Yes.
Because it doesn't matter how you, whether you're standing, kneeling, however it is, but your hands gotta be clean.
Yes.
And your heart gotta be pure. God will
Amen.
answer your
Amen.
prayer. God will answer any prayer that's sincere. That's why you got to
Amen.
be sincere and the right motive.
The right
I could
motive.
not go one more, not another minute without hearing from my daughter.
Amen.
Oh, it was, I was almost 5 days and I'm like, Lord, where's my baby? And I mean, my daughter's 30 something years old, but she's still my baby. You know? I mean,
Amen.
when your children go missing, they still, I don't care how old they get, they're still your
Yes.
babies. But God answered my prayer. And
Amen.
that's how when Minister Orville said he needed an answer. What happened? The bishop comes right down off the pulpit and gives him an answer.
Yes.
The God we serve today, a God that answers our prayers on the spot.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Have been praying for our house to get fixed for 5 years. And we kept looking at this house, Lord, fix our house. Lord, fix our house. We don't know where the money's coming Fix
from.
it, Jesus.
But let me tell you something. God provided the money and the person, the right person to fix our house.
Come on.
And I mean, it was a bonus the way he fixed our house. Only God will do things. Like
Amen.
nobody else. But prayer will do that. Prayer
Amen.
changes things. Prayer changes things like no other. But you need a relationship. Prayer establishes the relationship you have with your Father.
Come on.
I'm not calling him God. He is more than a God. He is my
Amen.
Father. I go to him when I'm hungry. I go to him when I'm thirsty. I go to him when I'm sick.
That's right,
I
my dear
go to
sister.
him when I need deliverance.
When
Thank
I'm
you,
tired and
Jesus.
sick and tired.
He's
I
everything.
go to him when I need anything. And he's
Yes.
always there. When you come into your house and your father, when you live with your father, I know a lot of people don't have their father there, but when you have a father in your home, what's the first thing you do? Hey, daddy, how you doing? You greet your father, you hug him, you kiss him, and you pay homage to him. Why? Because he's the high priest of the home. He's a
Yes.
provider. He makes sure all the needs of the house are met. That's the God that we serve. He's our
Hallelujah.
Father. He provides when no other person can provide like he does. That's
Amen.
why we give God all the glory that he deserves.
Amen.
Amen.
That's why when we
Hallelujah.
pray, the first thing we do is we adore him. You know why? Because of all the blessings that he has poured on us, how could we not? We take a lot of things for granted. The very breath that we breathe, that some people don't wake up. The life that we live. I was thinking about that when it was snowing over here. Over here, we got like almost a foot and a half of snow. And I started to think about all the people that don't have shelter.
I'm down to Georgia.
And I was like, Lord, have mercy. You
You
know,
see.
and I just started to thank God. Lord, I thank you for the warmth. I thank you for the roof over my head. I thank you for
Yes.
the food on my table. I thank you for my family. So much we take for granted.
So much the air
And
that we
we just
breathe.
gotta give him thanks every minute of the day. Even if he don't do one more thing,
He's
he
done
has
enough.
blessed us enough.
Amen. But more than enough.
More than enough.
Yes, Lord.
And that's the power of prayer.
Thank you,
The
Jesus.
power of prayer that you can pray for someone else. Because I just was praying for other people. Lord, bless them with a place to a shelter. You know, I found a cat in a storm called Riley. When we had the storm Riley in the snow, I think it was maybe 4 or 5 years ago. And I found a cat. She became our cat. She's been here since.
Look at
You
that.
know, and she was a kitten when we found her. She was maybe 6. Maybe 10 weeks old at the time. She was a baby and she's been here ever since. And she won't go out in the snow. She will not go out when it snows or when it's cold. She does
Smart.
not like it.
What
She
more will
remembers
God
that
do for
cold.
us?
She was out there for 3 days in that cold because we were snowed in at that time. And when we finally dug her out, she was so grateful and she won't leave.
I wouldn't
You
leave either.
know, you know, we need to be, we're like that with God, with our
Amen.
Father. I thank God for him saving me. You know, the blessing that he has been in my life, I don't know where I would be without him. Can you imagine? I started to think of my life if I had not gotten saved when I got saved, you know, and
Where will we be?
I thought about, they asked me to speak about choices matter on Saturday and the choice I made to have my son and how that one choice changed my life for the rest of my life because someone told me to abort my son.
Wow.
And if I had aborted him, I would have aborted destiny
Come
because my son
on.
is a minister. He ministers to in our Bible study. He's a minister of the gospel. Can you imagine had the choice I made to abort him? That was destiny. And look at how God's destiny, because of prayer, and I had a relationship with God because I heard him tell me, go and register and have your baby. And because I listened, when God spoke to me, I wasn't saved. But I knew who God was. And since I gave my heart to the Lord when I was pregnant and I was 19 years old, I have no regrets.
Amen.
And God has been with me ever since. I
Amen.
don't call him my God, I call him my father. I have a relationship with him.
Thank you, Jesus.
Been over 40 years, 41 years. Man, my father takes good care of me. And I thank
Amen.
God for that. Thank
Amen.
you, Jesus.
Yes.
That's what I
Amen.
want
Thank
to
you,
say. I
Jesus.
had so many scriptures, but you guys used them all. So
Well,
Ecclesiastes was the only one.
I put up a whole bunch on the comment section about prayer and engaging with God. And what prayer is just, divinity communicating with humanity, or
Yes.
humanity communicating with the divine. And
Vice
we
versa.
just and vice versa, yes. And one important thing that they said tonight, and I want you to keep this with you, is like when you pray, always have time to like sit down and listen and let God speak back to you. And
Amen.
like we spoke of so many ways of praying and receiving answers and praying, and like they said, there's so many ways. Like, there's not one way for you to pray. You can lock yourself in the bathroom, in your room, in the
In your
living room, in your
closet.
I used to pray when I used to drive to work, every morning, and I used to pray on my way back. I just used to feel that time to like tell God how my day went, and also like how my day didn't go. And vent, like they said, and vent my frustrations to him. But the main thing when praying, be honest, be
That's right.
sincere, be truthful, and also don't pray selfish prayers, right? God, pray with a pure heart, with pure motives, with pure intentions. We don't want to pray amiss, like the Bible say. We don't want to pray things that are out of the will of God. There's certainty. The Bible is clear, right? In black and white and
Very
red,
clear.
very clear on what is God, what is kingdom principle, and what is not. So we
That's
can't
right.
go and pray, like I said, for somebody that's married to become our husband or our wife, or other things that we know that are not scriptural.
That's
So
right.
if God call it sin, we can't go and pray and think that we're going to change God's mind so he can, like look over the sin, but just, give me what I selfishly want. And yes, adore him, worship him. And worshiping is also a way, because Paul and Silas, they worship in jail, and God delivered them from there. They invoked the presence of God, and that's what we wanted to speak. So with that, we are going to finalize this topic of today. The main title for this month, if you want to continue to follow us this whole month, every Monday, it's the power of prayer. Today we spoke on what is prayer, and next week we are going to be speaking on how to develop a prayer life. Amen. So, I mean, some people already know, but then for the ones that don't know, we're going to try to bring some clarity on how to develop a prayer life. Amen. And how to sustain it. Not only
Amen.
develop it, but sustain it. Because you can develop a prayer life, and then as time goes by, like I said, 1 week without prayer makes 1 week. And we can't go a whole week without praying and seeking the will of God. And we can be working for the Lord, and the Lord ain't working with us. That's a big no-no. And Julia said it best, following and the leading of the Holy Spirit, follow God's voice, follow his for direction, for protection, for provision, amen, and for power, because power comes through praying. The centurion prayed, and God sent one of the apostles to him, and he had to baptize him, and not only baptize him, but his whole family, and the Holy Ghost fell upon them, and then they also became, disciples for the Lord Jesus Christ. So What is prayer? Just communicate with the Father. Just a dialogue. It got to be a dialogue. It can't be a monologue. It's a dialogue.
That's right.
Amen. So we
Amen.
thank God for my brother, my
Yes.
sibling,
Amen.
whom I love dearly, all the way from La Ceiba, Atlantida, Honduras, Central America, to grace us with his presence again. I also thank God for First Lady
Amen.
Julia Merced, whoo, all the
Amen.
way from PA,
Yay.
Pennsylvania, and none other than my beautiful, engaging, loving, power-packed evangelist, Chrislyn Robinson, that has
Yes,
graced us
thank you.
again with her presence. We thank God
Yes,
for her.
thank you,
All the
Lord.
way from Jicey in New York City. So we thank God. And of course, your host right now today, that started this prayer thing. So like I said, this is a new year. Let's grow. Let's grow in the
Amen.
things of God. Next level. It's time for the next level.
Next
You
level.
can't
Amen.
stay on the bottom stair now. There's another stair we have to climb. So next level, 2024. Just say next level. We're moving on up, like the Jeffersons. Moving on up. We're
Hallelujah.
not staying in the
Yeah.
same place.
Thank you,
No.
Jesus.
Okay? We are not staying in the same place. It's time to move, people. It's time to
Yes.
grow in the things of God. It's time to go higher. And in God, that's my desire for this year, for me,
Yes.
for myself, and for everyone. Next level, level up. Level up.
Well,
Amen. Take the elevator to the other floor. Amen. Okay.
Jesus.
God bless you. With that,
God
we are
bless.
going to say that you have been empowered.
This is Kristen.
You are excellent.
You are enough.
And you are
Especially
especially
love.
loved. So we love you. God bless you. Have a fantabulous week, everyone. For everyone that's been on, listening, I've been watching you. I don't have time to like say everybody's name, but you know who you are. I love you dearly. Please share it on your page so others can be blessed likewise. I don't know about you, but I was blessed from the very beginning. And
Yes.
remember,
Me too.
telephone to glory is always on the
On the
line.
line.
You can
Call them up.
hear from
Call them
heaven almost
up.
every
Anytime.
time. It's a royal service, free for one and all. Telephone to glory always, always. It's always not clogged. It's you ain't gonna be holding and
Eyes
waiting.
never busy.
God was never busy. So whenever you call, and he can answer everyone at the same time because
That's
he's that
right.
type of God. Amen.
Amen.
So kudos to you. Happy New Year again. Happy Monday.
New
We
Year.
love you. God bless you.
God bless.
Amen.
Gotta go. I'm waiting.